Good morning students, welcome to offline classes for 7th standard. In part 1 we have discussed the chapter nutrition in plants. In that part 1 we have discussed about how plants they get the food. They are called as autotrophs because they prepare their own food. How they prepare their own food? By the process called photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is a complex process by utilizing carbon dioxide, water, and in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, so they produce the food. In this way, they are preparing their own food, hence they are called water autotrophs. So majorly, the nutrition is majorly divided into two types. One is autotrophic nutrition, one more is heterotrophic nutrition. Autotrophic nutrition is takes place in plants and they prepare their own food. So here, the one more kind of preparation of food and way of getting food, that is other modes of nutrition. That is, here some plants they don't have chlorophyll in them, then how they get food? See, here if the plants they contain chlorophyll, they can prepare their own food. But these plants, some plants they don't have chlorophyll in them, then how they prepare their food, or how they get food how they fulfill their needs, nutrients. So here some plants which grow on other plants or which live on other plants, and why they live on other plants, they get all the necessary things like food, shelter and everything from their particular plants. So they grow on other plants. Why they grow on other plants? And they grow on other plants for getting of all the necessary things for their survival, like food, shelter and water. Example here, Cuscuta. Cuscuta is a plant which grow on other plant for the getting of food and shelter. And this kind of mode of reproduction is called a parasitic mode of reproduction. So here example is what? Cuscuta. Cuscuta is called a parasite. Parasite means what? They get the food and shelter from the host. Host here on which they get the benefits. Such kind of plant they call it a host. From host, it gets all the necessary things, or it fulfills all the basic needs. So that this kind of mode of nutrition is called what? A parasitic mode of nutrition, and Cuscuta is what? A parasite. Okay. The another here, have you heard that some plant which get the food from the animals, and we can call as them non-vegetarians. So means here some plants which get the food from other animals. By example here, one of the plant which traps the insects and they eat the insect and they can fulfill their needs. Example here called a pitcher plant. A pitcher plant which traps the insects and get the food from those trapped insects. Such kind of plants are called the insectivorous plants. One more example here called Drosera. Drosera and pitcher plants are the two examples of animal plants which get the food from by the trapping of insects. From them they get the food. So here this mode of nutrition is called the insectivorous. See here, they get the food from, or they eat the insect, hence they are called the insectivorous plants. Next one, so here some plants which gets the food from dead and decaying matter. So here you might be see that mushrooms, have you heard mushrooms? And even the some kind of fungus which develops on the bread, some fungus which develops on the coconut, some fungus which develops on the lemon that we have discussed in the previous class. So those which are the black colored substance which is developed on them, they get the food from particular places. So they get the food from dead and decaying matter of plants or animal source. They get the food from dead and decaying matter. This way of getting, or this mode of nutrition, is called what? The saprophytic nutrition. Example is what? A mushroom. So mushrooms which get the food from a dead and decaying matter. So they grow on the dead and decaying matter. So from there they get the food input from that particular part. So they are called as what? A saprophytes. Example is what? A mushrooms. The next one, so here symbiosis. Symbiosis means here both independent, dependent on each other. See here, the host is benefited to the parasitic organism. The parasitic organism is benefited to the host. So here both are mutually, they are interdependent on each other. Such kind of mode of nutrition is called what? Symbiosis. Example here, lichens. So here, for these lichens, which are dependent on other organisms and they get benefited from the host, and the host get the benefits from the parasitic organisms. So here parasites and the host both are interdependent on each other. Such mode of nutrition is called what? Symbiosis. So these are all the different kinds of modes of nutrition. Some they are getting food from the host, some they get food from the insect, some they get food from the dead and decaying matter, some they are dependent on a host and host is dependent on a parasite. So these are the different kinds of modes of nutrition. So by these way, in these plants, in these plants, they don't have any chlorophyll in them. So because of not having chlorophyll in them, so they can't able to prepare their own food. So they are dependent on other animals or plants here. So here, so this is about how the other plants, they prepare their own food. So here, the next topic of the chapter, that about how nutrients are replenished in the soil. How nutrition are replenished. So as you know that the plants require many number of things are for the growth and development. So as you know, they need carbon dioxide, they need oxygen, they need water. So the even they need some other nutrients for the plant growth and development. So they need phosphorus, they need nitrogen, they need iron, they need sulfur, so they need potassium. So these they get from the soil. But in the, we have seen that farmers usually timely they used to supply these nutrients to the plants, like fertilizers, chemical fertilizers. Those chemical fertilizers which contain water, these nutrients, like NPK. What is NPK? Nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. So these, they are very important for the plant body for growth and development. So these timely they have to supply to the plant body for the growth and development. If plants they absorb they absorb more quantity from the soil. So when the soil is less of these nutrients from the soil, so timely we need to supply. Okay, how to replenish? So here, if sometimes the plants, when the soil is lack of these nutrients, where the soil is not nutrients, they need main called nitrogen. So here the nitrogen is present more in atmosphere. So this gases, it is in the form of water, gas. This gaseous nitrogen is not useful for the plant. So why the plants, they directly they won't absorb this gaseous nitrogen from the atmosphere. So they need, it has to be converted into another form. So there is some bacteria are responsible for the converting of gaseous nitrogen into some useful substance, that is rhizobium. Rhizobium is one of the bacteria which will responsible for converting of atmospheric nitrogen into useful substances, like useful substance like nitrates. These nitrates are useful for the plant body for the growth and development. So here rhizobium plays very very important role here to converting of water atmospheric nitrogen into nitrates. So these nitrates again it is utilized by the plant body for growth and development. So these are the way of how we need to replenish, how we need to enrich the nutrients in the soil. Here the enriching of nitrogen in the soil, there is one of the important bacteria which is responsible here, that is called a rhizobium, plays very important role. Here this is the topic of all these topics. Modes of nutrition, how it takes place in the plants. In next class, we'll discuss how nutrition takes place in animals. Okay, thank you.